And don't be here, you're trying to have the most points by creating the best champagne and gaining prestige. You'll be going to the vineyard and planting grapes, but also harvesting depending on which grapes are around it. And once you have those grapes in your presses, you can press them in the cellar and creating either bottles or barrels. That's important because selling them to certain markets, some of them only want bottles, and they're better if they come out of one of your other presses. Others might only want barrels, and some can take either. And it has an interesting action selection mechanism as you're selecting an action. Cost has to do with the lowest of where you are, and strength has to do with where you are on that action. So as the game goes on, things become more costly, but you get more powerful too. You're also trying to fulfill certain goals throughout the game, and you're also trying to work your way up the prestige track, either buying your way up or doing certain things with excellence. Because not only do these give you straight points at the end of the game, they help you multiply other things you've collected throughout the game to give you even more points. So let's see if you have what it takes to become the best champagne house around.